plastik. Oke. Hello everyone, my name is Chan Melisondra and today I'm gonna teach you on how to paint this wonderful portrait of an eagle. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed it, and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications of my new videos and tutorials. You can also see the materials needed on the screen. You can see there the 5 limited colors, the brushes that we're gonna need, and all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now and I'm going to do the underpainting first. So you already see here the sketch, so I start with the sketch first so that I can put the background faster. Okay, so yeah, I let it dry first, the sketch, and then I will be using this number 2 flat brush. I think it's a 1.5 inch flat brush, or I think it's, you can also use 2 inches. Okay, I have here the raw umber. I can do the underpainting first. Yeah, that's why I'm using the dark color, everyone, so that I can use a darker colors, or I can still see the details there. So I am using the raw umber directly. Even if I'm using the raw umber, you can still see most of the details, most of the sketch. Okay. And I'm gonna mix now a little bit of purples. So this will be the sky, everyone. Blue and the red, and then white. You can make the background darker. I like the background to be darker, everyone, because I want everything to be focused on the eagle. I want also to make the background a little bit of orange or pink, so I'm gonna use more red and white. There. There, okay. Let's add darker tones. So I want this part to be darker. So as you can see, everyone, I like the background. It's soft now. So I'll just make the background soft. There, okay. Blue and the red. Cannot a bit of, you can add a bit of darks, everyone. Or I can even add a little bit of greenish or something. Maybe I'll make this part a little bit greenish. And the upper part will be a bit of purple, maybe here. There. A bit of reddish purple, and then I want to also show some greenish tone, but it will be darker with some red, blue, yellow with some red. So here, let's put it here. There, and also here. There you go. So we have now our background. We can retouch it later on, everyone. We can think what will be the best to put on that background. So for now, let's just do something like that. Okay, just make it dark, something like that. Because later on we can enhance those background. We can put anything we want as long as it will look good. Yeah. So for now, I'm gonna make this stand out. This part here. This is a portrait, so I'm gonna do my best to make this part glow up, something like that. Okay, so I'll be using this bristle, and I think it's number 8 nylon flat brush. It's a medium size flat brush. I'll add first some darks, so maybe I'll add first here, or maybe here. I'll start it here, some shades, some gray shades. Okay, so I'm gonna use this blue and the red. It should be equal, everyone. And then some white, a bit of white. You can add a little bit of amber so that the color will become much more like gray or grayish. There. So this part will be a bit of dark. Ha ha ha! Actually, I'm just following my reference, everyone. So, on my reference, this is dark. So I downloaded this photo from Pixabay. So honestly, thank you for the upload of this photo. Maybe the number. Little bit of gray is there. And also here on the side of the here, this part, okay? So we have now a bit of gray stone. There you go. Yeah, and then I'm gonna darken this part, everyone. So I'll be using, because I'm not using black, I will be using dark purple. Blue and the red. Okay, so just fill it everything here with the dark purple, everyone. Okay, so here maybe a little bit lighter on the top, okay. Yeah, maybe I'm gonna put a little bit of white and some more red. Maybe a little bit of amber to make it much more brownish. bit of romber. Yeah, you can mix with the romber to make it much more gray. Yes. There you go. I'm gonna add more. Add more darks here. I want to clean it up, everyone. I want to make it look clean. Those darks there, okay? And if you are painting, we just follow what I'm doing, everyone. Just always have fun. So as you can see now, it looks dark. It actually looks black. Okay, so yeah, I think this one will be great for now. I will now focus on this part on the head. So let's add some bit of details of what. Usually this beak here. I'm going to make it a realistic beak. Okay. So clean your brushes and your brush, because you are mixing another color, especially those yellows and reds. So make sure it will not turn out green. So I have this yellow, red, and then yellow. And it will turn out your orange. So yeah, I'm gonna make this part orange first. Yeah, that's good. And then a little bit of orange on the surrounding the eyes. There. Okay, so slowly I'm gonna try to touch and make it look realistic. So I'm gonna do a bit of shading, everyone. So yeah, I'll try to add some darks. So I have here the orange. I'm gonna put some raw umber, red, and the yellow. There, okay. And then I will try some white and then yellow. To brighten the light color, everyone, especially the yellow, you can add white first or the light yellow. I'm gonna mix it with a little bit of orange. There you go. That's great. So slowly everyone becoming looking realistic. So I'll be using now the pure yellow here. And then a bit of orange. Okay, yeah, so we have now a very beautiful beak. Yeah, I think we can call it beak, everyone. So I have here the raw amber, no, the blue, sorry, the blue and the red to have a dark color, dark purple. So this will be my black, everyone. I am using the small brush. There you go. And in here, let's add a little bit of darks also. There. Okay. I will use a little bit of raw amber with some yellow. I'll touch this part here, but I'm gonna blend a little bit. Even here, I will try to add a bit of darks. So that will be shades, everyone, to make it look better and realistic. There, so even the beak now looks good and it looks a bit realistic. Yeah, I want it to look shiny, everyone, so I'm gonna use this white. There, okay. A bit of amber and white with some yellow. You can add a little bit of darks here, or some spots, white spots, something like that. Okay, there you go. So you have now, yeah, beautiful eagle. Yeah, I want to paint now the eye, because the eye drawn will make it look better. Yeah, maybe I will be using a raw amber with a bit of white. So I'm gonna put it a shade here. Okay, so I'm gonna add a little bit of lights there. Maybe I will be using a smaller brush, because in the eyes, everyone, we need to make it detailed, something like that. So it's very important, okay? I'll be using, I think, this raw amber with a bit of yellow and then white. A bit of yellow, yeah. Okay, and then I'm gonna try to add a bit of white, some pure white. And even here. There. I
And some dots here also. And I'm gonna use more umber. I'm gonna shade also here.
Okay. And then we can use now the dark purple, red, and the blue.
So the eye of the eagle, everyone, has a thicker dark lines. Yeah, something like that, as you see here.
Okay, there you go. So you have now a wonderful eye of the eagle. Okay, so I'll start now to add some darks, everyone. Some grayish darks here everywhere, so it will complete the entire look or details. So I have the gray and the white. I'm gonna light umber, but I'm gonna put some umber. Not light umber, light purple. Sorry about the dog, but. So yeah, here. It's a grayish tone. Slowly we can put here. And then also here. There, okay. And even here, everyone, just small gray tones. And then here we can put. And then here, but we start also here. If you want to make a gray tones, everyone, just use the raw another purple with the raw umber. And then here we can put. And then here on the bottom part. Okay, so I'm going to start now adding some. Oh no, wait, I'm going to add also here. It's a bit of raw umber with a yellow.
And then white. So we'll put it here, everyone. It's a bit of yellowish tones. You can do it by doing some dots. There. And then here, but maybe I will make it a bit darker. So raw umber, red, and then yellow. So it's a bit darker, browns. Go. Yum. It looks good. It looks, for me now, realistic, everyone. I like that. So I'm gonna add some dots also here. Okay, now I am excited on adding the mid-tones, everyone, or what we call lights. Okay, so first we're gonna use this blue and the red, or the reddish purple and then white. Okay, so we can make it a reddish purple one. Put some more red and then white. There. Okay. Some more red. I'm gonna put it here. Slowly, everyone, build the stones. So I'll be doing it slowly. Thank you.
Yeah. These are middle tones, everyone. This is not yet the highlights. Highlights will be on a different level of intensity. Okay, so let's add some white. Clean your brush, clean your brush, clean your brush, clean your brush. We have here the pure white. So I'm gonna separate it here. So same thing, everyone, do it slowly and also one by one, like what I am doing now. There, okay. So here also, everyone, you can add a bit of lights here. There. Okay, sorry about the noise of the children, everyone. I don't know what they are doing. I think they're, of course, playing. Okay, so yeah. So here I'm gonna put more whites. So one by one, everyone, build those lights and darks and midtones. There, okay. Okay, so I think I need a smaller brush. There, you can make that part brighter over here. You can make the paint thicker, everyone, like that. Sorry about the children, everyone. There, okay, you can see now the bright, the lights, okay? Okay. There, okay. Yeah, you can see now, everyone, those lights there. It is now becoming realistic. Yeah, even like that, everyone, it looks good. Even if I still have to polish everything. But for me, at this stage, it looks good now. So yeah, I like it. It is becoming realistic now. And I think I like to darken the background around. I want this painting to be the center of everything here. Okay, so I'm going to use a smaller brush now because I want to add details. Slowly. So yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to build up more details. I'm using this small brush, everyone. This is the liner brush. Okay. So here, everyone, there is a light there in the back. There. Okay. Okay, that's it. So I'll be using also some light umber. I'm gonna mixing it here. I'm gonna put more white. There you go. Yeah. It's a light purple, everyone, that I'm using. There you go. It's a light purple. So this brush, everyone, it gives a better details,
especially those tiny details that it will create a beautiful tone.
So just do it slowly.
So as you can see now,
here also I'm gonna put a bit of details.
We'll use now some white.
So good.
Yeah, I love it, everyone. It looks simple, but it looks realistic. Yeah, it looks fierce. Okay, the eyes, everyone, look so good, and even the beak, it looks so good. It's not perfect. I know that it's not perfect, but I think it looks good. And for me, I'm very, very happy with that. Okay, so let's continue.
So I'm gonna put some dots here.
Just a little bit of yellow. I'm gonna lighten this part. can see now, it's bright. And I'm gonna think I'm gonna put some white here. Yeah, to make it look it's shining. Okay. So what else? A little bit of darks. I think, so here, everyone, I'm going to add now, starting to add details that part there. Yeah, here. So I'll be using the blue and the red. So I think I have no red. There, I'm going to put a little bit of umber. To make the color look more brownish. I'm gonna make it a little bit more brownish. So here, Ron, let's make it a little bit darker. I'm going to make it lighter also. And some blue color. Some red. Then some white.
Yeah, I'm gonna add a little bit transition between light and dark, everyone. Yeah, here. Yeah. Yeah, to add a bit the transition between the light. Yeah, there. I'm gonna mix more. You can add more blue, everyone. A little bit of white. There. Okay. So here also, everyone, I'm gonna make it more light. Or I'm gonna make it lighter. Just add a lot of feathers there, a little bit of reddish purple. And also here. Okay. And then darker tones also. Especially here. So this one, it will look more like feathers now. And here one, I'm gonna make it dark. So I'm gonna mix for blue and the red for darker purple, and then I'm gonna put a little bit of umber. I'm gonna add a bit of umber to make it not so much dark. Okay. Also here, let's make it darker. There. So I'm just polishing it, everyone, to make it look good and better. To make it much more looking realistic, okay? There you go. So, that's why this brush, everyone, the liner brush is very good in adding the details. Because the tinier the details, everyone, the better the better it will become. So just add more details as you can to make the painting look much more realistic. Okay, so the tinier the details also, it will actually look good. Okay, so yeah. So as you can see now, a bit far, it looks good, and it looks really realistic. I like that. Okay, so I'll just add tinier details there, and yeah, I think I am almost finished. I'm almost done, everyone. Sorry. So here, I'll just try to retouch a bit. So I have here the blue and the red, and then some white, and then raw umber. motorcycles are really noisy. There, okay. And let's add a bit of colors also here. There. Okay, so I am going now to add some, I think these details are a bit complicated, everyone. It might take time, but I think the time will be worth it. So I'm gonna use this blue umber and then some white, some more red. So it will be something like this. So these are feeders, everyone, and on the feeders there are some designs on the, yeah. There, okay. So that is just the beginning. Okay. So this part will be a little bit of abstract. Okay, now I'm going to add some shades. Blue umber and the blue. Yeah, maybe I'll be using this flat brush, everyone, so that I can finish it faster. This small flat brush, blue umber and the blue. No, red and the blueprint, sorry. Bit of umber. Just follow the pattern, everyone. Actually, we do not need to copy everything that what we saw, what we are seeing on the actual feeders. Actually, we just get the pattern where it goes, and then just replicate it. But you can also do it copy one by one. But I tell you, it takes a lot of time to do that. Okay. Then I'm gonna add a little bit of white. Okay, yeah, even like that, it looks a bit better now. Okay. Yeah, and then I'm gonna make it lighter. Especially the edge of one, I'm gonna make it lighter. So you have the raw umber plus yellow and red and then white. Talaga, you can make it better, everyone, by adding more details. Okay, maybe I will not overdo it, everyone. Actually, you can still do more here, but for me, I think that it will be enough here on this part. I'll just try to retouch a bit more here. Some of the black feeder, everyone, feeders. You can still see a bit of brownies there. Okay. There. Okay, so I will let you see everything, and I will try to make the background better. So maybe I want the background to be dark, everyone. I want to hide more there, so I think that would be great. Yeah, so yeah, I want to make the background darker, because I want to put it a little bit of clouds, everyone. Maybe some pink clouds, something like that. Yeah, and a bit of trees there in the background. A little bit of light, trees that hit by the light. So yeah, I want it to be really dark. Okay, so I'm gonna put, yeah, I'm gonna put some blue and then red. So you can use this bristle cut brush. Over the blue and the red. Can also put some more umber and more blue there. This will be some trees, everyone. Some background trees. Okay, trees on the background. Okay, and in here I will try to put a smaller type of clouds, but I want the background to be darker, everyone. So blue and the red and then white.
Yeah.
Blue and the red. Some white. Maybe more blue, more red, yeah. I think I'm gonna put some blue. Yeah, I just want to have a dark sky, everyone. Dark purple sky. Okay. In here. Okay, so we can put a bit of highlights and maybe some darks here. So I'm gonna mix for a bit of purples. Can also put some darks. Yeah. Okay. Actually, it looks like some sort of this one, but some sort of mountains. Yeah. It's also here. Yeah, we can make it darker. I'm going to add a little bit of white. There, okay. I'm gonna add red and then kind of white to add a bit of highlights here, even here for one. You can make it a bit of abstract.
There, okay. As I can see, it even look like mountains, everyone. That's good. I don't intend that to be look like mountains. But actually, a mountain can do. It will be good also. So yeah, just make it look more an abstract background, everyone. Actually, it doesn't need to be that perfect. Yeah, I don't care what you will see there. It's like mountains or clouds. So yeah. Anyway, for me, that is just our background. Okay. Yeah. I think that looks good now. I'm going to try to put now the trees there, the pine trees. So yeah, that will be my final application, everyone. So I'm gonna mix for dark color, blue, red, and the raw umber. Just want to make it dark. So this will be a pine trees. So just how can I do it? So just tapping technique. There, that's good. You can add like a tower here. Lines to the top, and then you can put down the details of the pine trees, the leaves, I mean. And add more here. There. Okay, and also here. Okay. A lot more here. There you go, and then I'm going to add now the greens. So I didn't use so much yellow in this painting, everyone. Yellow and the blue. I just want to have a beautiful green, or green. And then we can add a bit of highlights on the right side, because it's the light here is on the right side. And not so much, don't overdo it. Just tapping technique. hair. So yeah, I am done, everyone, and I love the result. It looks so good. It looks simple, and I like the eagle there. It looks so giant, yeah, because of the small details in the background. But I'll just say that this is a far. The eagle is far from those trees on the background. Yeah. Okay, everyone. So I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like and some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.